In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily find out what key your kick is in, and how you can tune it to match the key of your track. So, keep on watching.
This is a Firewalk production.
Many music producers tune their kicks so that it matches the key of the track. This can help make the kick sit better in the mix. However, not all kicks need to be tuned, and a lot of times the perceived pitch of a kick will be subjective. What I mean by that is what may sound in key to me may not sound in key to you. What I'm about to show you will help you avoid that problem. So when should you tune your kicks? Well, unfortunately, there's no definitive answer to that. It all depends on the kick and the track. You'll just have to use your ears. I know, that may sound cliche, but there's really no substitute for your ears. If it sounds good, it sounds good. Considering what I've just said, you can imagine that tuning a kick by ear and getting it to sound perfect can be quite tricky. Fortunately, there are tools that can help us, which I'm about to demonstrate. We're going to be using a plugin called G-Tune. This plugin will analyze the pitch of the kick and tell us what key it's in. Note that this is a free plugin. I have included the download link in the description below, so you can go ahead and grab it if you want and try this yourself. Here I have a blank project. Let's imagine this track is going to be written in A minor. So let's find a decent kick and then drag it into the channel rack. This one sounds fine. Make sure to route it to a mixer insert. Now let's make a standard 4-on-the-floor kick pattern and place it in the playlist. I'm now going to tune this kick to A so that it will be in key. Select the mixer insert we routed it to and load the G-Tune Effect plugin. When I press play, you'll see that the G-Tune plugin is analyzing the kick, giving us its relative pitch. Obviously, it's not quite in key yet. Remember, what determines pitch is frequency. In this example, the note we're after is A, and the lowest possible frequency for that note is 27.5 Hz. One octave up will be 55 Hz. One octave above that will be 110 Hz, and so on. You get the idea. You can find this information online. Just Google frequencies of musical notes, and it should pop right up. I found several websites with this information. I have also included the link to this page in the description below. The G-Tune plugin is displaying the frequency as well as the key. This makes it easier to fine-tune. As you can see from the chart, to get the kick tuned to A, we need to be exactly at 55 Hz. It's not quite there yet, so let's start tuning. In order to tune the kick, we have to open the channel rack and then click on the kick. This will open the sampler. Now we can start tweaking the pitch knob. Before we continue, note that when pitching kicks, you should only pitch ever so slightly. If you overdo it, it will sound really bad. You only want to make very small adjustments up or down. Some kicks won't sound good even when they're tuned just slightly. So again, use your ears. When you start tuning, pay close attention to the information displayed in the G-Tune plugin. You can see that A is now favored quite a bit, and we're also very close to 55 Hz. I think this is as close as we're going to get. The kick should now be in key. Generally, you'll get a long way by just using your ears, but in cases like this, it can be really helpful to have some visual input from various analyzers as well. That's it! I'm uploading new tutorials and templates every week, so make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you won't miss out. Is there any specific tutorial you'd like me to make? Or perhaps you have a question? Just leave me a comment below. I hope this was helpful. If you liked the video, please like, share, and comment. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more tutorials.